broke like a lot of records.
The MLB Division Series on TBS is presented by Budweiser. Reach for a Budweiser, the perfect balance of flavor and refreshment. Open up a world of taste. And brought to you in part by Holiday Inn, the official hotel of Major League Baseball. By AIG, for insurance, investments, retirement. AIG, the strength to be there. And by Levi's, the original. Find your fit at Levi.com.
So with 90 wins, the Diamondbacks have home field throughout this National League playoff as we come back to Chase Field. And you wonder how much of a home field advantage it'll be for that. Let's go down to the field to Mark Fine.
Yeah, Dick, you know, you mentioned they got home field advantage throughout, but when they drew the Cubs, that kind of changed a little bit. You see the Cubs train not far from here in the spring. There are also a lot of Chicago transplants in this area. A lot of concern on the part of the Diamondbacks organization, so much so they started a campaign called Take Back This Field. You'll actually see things in the stadium tonight. If the Cub fans start chanting, "Let's go Cubs," on the scoreboard, it'll show "Beat the Cubs" in hopes that the hometown fans will drown out the Cub fans that are here. Guys, I'm thinking about 80%, 20% at the most, so I don't think they might have been a little too concerned about how many Cub fans would be here.
All right, Mark, and for over 50 years, the Cubs have had their spring training here in Arizona. And this is, so we're set to go as Alfonso Soriano stepping in, leading off for the Cubs. And as dangerous a hitter as there was in the big leagues in the months of September. A club record 14 home runs, breaking Ernie Banks' record by one. And the first pitch is bounced on one hop to Mark Reynolds. One pitch, Soriano's retired. So Alfonso Soriano, who also had seven leadoff game home runs to set a major league record, followed in the batting order by Jacques Jones, who sets up right now, and Lee and Ramirez, the big 3-4 hitters. Mark DeRosa, job at second base. Giovanni Soto coming up from the minor leagues and wins the catching job for the start of the series. Ryan Theriault hitting eighth at shortstop. And here is Jacques Jones, and the first pitch outside, ball one.
Well, we talked to many of the people at the Diamondbacks talking about Brandon Webb, Cy Young Award winner last year, even better this year. Secondary pitches are better, curveball, changeup, and he gets a ton of ground balls.
Second lowest earned run average in the National League. Bob Melvin, the manager, who has done a great job of adjusting to the youth of the club, and the fact, as you pointed out at the top, that there's almost a different hero every day.
Yeah, they're lucky. They got a couple of veterans in Burns and Tony Clark, who's playing tonight at first base, that really helped keep those young guys in line.
Pitch breaks inside to Jones. Three balls and one strike. So Brandon Webb facing a Chicago lineup, and Derek Lee, one of the big sluggers on deck, that produced 45 home runs in the month of September. And Jacques Jones walks, so the first base runner of the ball game with one out.
Well, you see his numbers there, 18 wins. That's two more than he had last year. He reduced his ERA. Strikeouts are up, 18 more strikeouts this season as he just keeps getting better and better, especially on this field that's a very slick infield.
And especially since this is a pretty good hitter's ballpark, and with the roof open, it's going to really be a plus for right-handed hitters. Big swing and a miss by Derek Lee. Lee is hitting 317 as you take a look at the panorama of this ballpark, and it's a quirky park because of some overhang in the outfield. The Diamondbacks won four out of the six games between the teams in the regular. Did not go around, says first base umpire Sam Holbrook. Ed Montague is the home plate umpire for game number one.
You can see from the side here, Lee just able, he's so strong, to keep that bat back from being a swing.
National League batting champion 2 years ago and missed 100 games last year with a broken wrist. And earlier in the year, Lou Piniella said, well, we can go either way. We can play with a little bit of speed or with power. But as we saw in the month of September, they're going to rely on the long ball. Here's the 1-1 pitch, fouled off to the right. And the count 1-2 to the Cubs' first baseman.
Well, you see Derek Lee asking home plate umpire Ed Montague, was that a strike? Because that is what Webb does to right-handed hitters who are hitting only 199 against him. He just rushes them inside, doesn't allow them to get their arms out in front. Really just throws that sinker ball in on their hands.
Runner at first is Jacques Jones. And the off-speed pitch swung on and missed, strike three. So Derek Lee goes down, and the first strikeout for Brandon Webb, and there are two gone.
Well, here's the defense for the Diamondbacks. Chris Young in center field has been outstanding all season long. Augie Ojeda, who took over for Orlando Hudson, has been a steady influence at second base. And Chris Snyder and Brandon Webb have formed a great tandem, with Snyder having a great ability to throw runners out.
They have a great rapport, Doug Snyder and Brandon Webb, talking about it the other day, as the first pitch to Aramis Ramirez is in for a strike. And there is Chris Snyder. Ramirez leading the Cubs with 101 runs batted in this year. Has been a terrific clutch hitter for several seasons. And a slow hit ground ball to second base. Ojeda makes the play, and the side is retired. Cubs lead one, and the Diamondbacks come up in the first.
Sign up today and buy the sleeker Razor 2. Verizon Wireless. It's the network.
Backpack. $20. Being with people who understand you. Priceless. There are some things money can't buy. For discount stores, there's MasterCard.
And we're back here at Chase Field as the Diamondbacks coming up in the bottom of the first inning. Let's take a look at the batting order. And Chris Young, the rookie, and he has been quite a catalyst for the Arizona Diamondbacks and a former Chicago White Sox farmhand. Eric Burns, however, has been the inspiration of the club. Eric Burns, the top hitter and RBI man for this team. And they're not household names by any stretch of the imagination, but as Ron mentioned, you know, they get some game-winning walk-off hits, and they just have a way of doing it. So ready to go, and Carlos Zambrano's first pitch to Chris Young is in for a call strike. And a ground ball up the middle and a base hit. So here's Chris Young with the turn, hitting only 7, but leading the D-backs with 32 home runs.
Well, this is what Zambrano will do early in the game. He usually just comes out firing that fastball. 2 fastballs in a row. That second one hits straight back up the middle, back through the box by Chris Young.
So Chris Young, who has 27 stolen bases, is on at first. And we take a look at Carlos Zambrano, 18-13 his record, a career high for him. And 9th in the National League in strikeouts, and a fastball to Stephen Drew, the shortstop, is in for a call strike. Stephen Drew, disappointing year at the plate, although he did hit a home run against the Cubs at Wrigley Field that really started the Diamondbacks on one of their midseason surges. And Chris Young takes off, and the throw to second base, and it's not in time. So Lupinella has the man he wants behind the plate, and Giovanni Soto with a strong arm. But Chris Young got a good jump, stole 27 during the year, and now he's in scoring position.
Well, most of the time, you steal bases on the pitcher, and that's what happened with Zambrano. Big jump by Chris Young at first base. No chance for Soto, even with that strong, accurate throw.
And this is the way the Diamondbacks are going to have to play it against the Cubs.
You see the bench coach, Kirk Gibson, there. He is in charge of the base running for the Diamondbacks.
And Drew takes a big cut and misses. 1-2. Drew hit 12 homers and drove in 60 runs during the regular season. Eric Burns is on deck for the Diamondbacks in the postseason for the 4th time in their 10-year life. And the world champions, of course, 6 years ago. And a fastball called, 3rd strike, and Drew is out of there. So Zambrano chalks up the first out here in the bottom of the first.
Well, just a fastball. Looks like Drew might have been guessing maybe that Zambrano was going to come in with a breaking pitch in the dirt. He didn't. Surprise him with that fastball that caught a lot of the plate.
Lou Piniella who has one world championship to his credit, that over the Oakland A's back in 1990, and getting the Cubs into the playoffs this year in his first season. Eric Burns taking ball one outside. Burns' best year in his career. And a guy that really exemplifies the spirit of what this team has become.
Yeah, he's one of those guys that runs hard in every play, and he's inspired all the other young baby backs to sprint when they're on the bases.
Checking Young with the lead, and the slider is away, 2-0 to Burns.
This is what you get when you get Carlos Zambrano. A lot of walking around the mound, a lot of stalking, a lot of talking to himself, trying to get himself going. A tug at the uniform.
So two balls and no strikes to Burns. And that nearly hit him. That pitch is inside. And so Zambrano falls behind in 3-0. MLB postseason in Espanol live. MLB postseason Spanish language feed available via SAP. On deck is Tony Clark, one of the gray beards on this Arizona team. 3-0 pitch and a strike. Big question for Carlos Zambrano. Can he control his emotions and stay focused? And many times it's the bloop hits that really get under his skin. Some of the soft singles. Comes back, broken back, ground ball, slowly hit. Terrio making the play. Going to third is Young. And there are two out for the Diamondbacks and a runner at third. And here's Tony Clark, switch hitter. And batting left-handed against Zambrano. Had 17 homers and 51 runs batted in. And 15 of his 17 homers came from the left side of the plate. There's Young with the lead at third. Singled, stole second, two out. First pitch outside, ball one.
That Zambrano struggles with his control sometimes. You'll see him walking around again. He has this thing that he works with Larry Rothschild. When he struggles with his control, he tries to regroup. There's Larry, pitching coach for the Cubs. Gets behind the mound, tries to regroup, think about his mechanics, and get back to throwing strikes.
And normally, Ron, he's a fast worker, and the Cubs like it that he does take his time and just calm himself down when he's not on. Here's the 2-0 pitch and falls behind 3-0. So for the second time in this first inning, Carlos Zambrano has fallen behind, three balls and no strikes. On deck is Mark Reynolds, the impressive third baseman. Runner at third is Chris Young. And the pitch in, letter high for a strike, 3-1. Zambrano pitched better on the road this year than he did at Wrigley Field. He won 12 and lost only 4 with an earned run average of 3.06. Here's the 3-1. In for the strike. Clark thought it was inside ball 4, but Montague gave it the quick strike call, and it's now 3-2.
Well, you see here on the pitch tracks, this ball looked inside to me. Let's see where it is on our pitch track. Yeah, looks inside. That's a pitch, though, that you want Tony Clark to take. That ball's too on the corner, too close to the corner to take a swing at that.
Count is full to Tony Clark. Young, the runner at third, as Zambrano trying to pitch out of trouble in the first inning, and does, as Clark strikes out. So Zambrano strikes out two, and the Diamondbacks leave a runner at third. No score after one.
I am your bank manager.
Hi, Dr. Andy from Evergreen Kia, introducing the all-new Kia Rondo. Looks like it's from outer space, but let's check out the inner space. The Rondo fit all these people inside and still have room for all your other things. With up to 30 miles to a gallon and payments of $179 a month. And with the 10-year, 100,000-mile warranty, this little baby will save you nothing but cash. So take immediate delivery of your all-new Kia Rondo only at Evergreen Kia, 92nd and Western. Take good care of my Kia, and we'll take good care of you.
And, of course, the Diamondback fans ready to remind the Cub fans that it's been since 1908 and they won the World Series, as if the Cub fans have to be reminded. Here's Cliff Floyd leading off the top of the second inning against Brandon Webb, and the first pitch is in for a strike. Floyd will be platooning with Matt Merton in right field. Merton will get the call tomorrow night against Doug Davis, the left-hander for Arizona. Hit 284 with 9 homers, 45 runs batted in, takes a big swing on the off-speed pitch, and the count 0-2.
Floyd, one of those players that you love to have on your bench, that left-handed bat, still very potent.
This is his first year with the Cubs, played with the Mets for 4 previous years as a pitch is taken for a ball, 1-2. And a new baseball goes out to Carlos, or to Brandon Webb. Webb is 4-1 in his career against the Cubs. Lost to them at Wrigley Field this year. And a good sinker, and Floyd goes down, and that'll be the second strikeout of the game and one out in the second inning. Taking a look at the umpires working the series, Ed Montague is the home plate umpire. Sam Hoberg is at first. Greg Gibson at second. Mike Everett will be at third, and down the lines, Mike Riley will be down the left field line and Mark Carlson in the right field line. And the normal crew chiefs in the regular season are Montague and Riley. Riley will work home plate if the series goes the full 5 games. DeRosa takes strike 1 with 1 out in the second. And a fly ball hit to right field. It's going to drop for a base hit. Jeff Salazar is over there in a hurry, so the Cubs have their second base runner and their first hit of the game with one out here in the second. Mark DeRosa on base.
Well, the great thing about when you talk about the umpires in this series, I know a lot of them. The home plate umpire, Eddie Montague, is just fantastic. He's player friendly. He has no problem with discussing the strike zone with players, and pitcher friendly. If you hit your spots over and over, he will sometimes open that plate up. He's not a traditional Questech umpire.
Of course, all you pitchers have known the tendencies of umpires when you played, and even now, as Giovanni Soto takes a ball 1. Soto wearing number 58, and that's because he is a raw rookie, played in just 18 games, but a major contributor down the stretch for the Cubs this year. And Lou Piniella started in this game 1, and Webb falls behind him 2-0.
Well, he had an amazing year this year in AAA minor league Pacific Coast Player of the Year. There's Jason Kendall, the veteran catcher, getting the seat tonight though for Soto.
As Kendall came over in the trade that sent Michael Barrett to San Diego shortly after that fight in the dugout with Carlos Zambrano. Meanwhile, Webb falls behind Soto, 3-0 with 1-1. Ball strike, 3-1. On deck is Ryan Terrio, the 8th hitter in the lineup for the Cubs tonight. There he is. Brandon Webb, unlike Zambrano, has a low-key approach and admits that he is nervous, but he's able to hide the nervousness a good deal of the time.
Yeah, he's one of those pitchers that you can never know whether he's winning by 5 runs or losing by 5 runs. Shows a lot of composure on the mound.
Lead at first by DeRosa, and he takes off, and the pitch is grounded to third. Reynolds has only one play, and that's the first. So DeRosa was running, and they took the double play out of it, and Soto is retired. 2 out, and DeRosa's at second.
Well, you'll see here as the runner takes off, you see Lou Piniella trying to play a little more upbeat game, trying to play a little more aggressively. Soto though, with the ground ball to Reynolds.
Pinella said he would use the hit and run more tonight, not at the top of the order so much because of Soriano's problems. Still bothered by the strained quad, but in the sixth, seventh, and eighth spots in the lineup. And here is Ryan Terrio rounding the shortstop, and the inning is over. The Cubs get a hit and leave a runner in scoring position after an inning and a half. No score here in Phoenix.
It's going to be some kind of good.
Grady Sizemore, 25.
What a catch by Sizemore.
Robinson Cano, 24.
All game over.
Applebaum, 26.
Swing and a miss.
Chris Young, 24. Cole Hamels, 23.
Struck him out.
You can call them stars of the future.
What a job by Carmona.
That's if you call October the future. There's only one postseason. There's only one Fall Classic. There's only one October.
This copyrighted telecast is presented by authority of the Office of the Commissioner of Baseball and may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form, and the accounts and descriptions of this game may not be disseminated without express written consent.
And we're back at Chase Field here in Phoenix. Dick Stockton along with Ron Darling. Mark Fine is with us as well. And Mark Reynolds leading off and swings and misses for strike one. Mark Reynolds came up from Double-A, and several of the D-backs have come up from Double-A and actually carried the team for 2 weeks when he came up in mid-May. Tom Brano misses with the slider. And the count one and one.
You know, he's given the responsibility of batting in the cleanup spot, too, and just did a fantastic job for the Diamondbacks. Again, anybody, anytime, it seems, for this young team.
One ball and two strikes, and, of course, took the place of Chad Tracy, who was one of the fixtures for the D-backs, who had knee surgery in September. So a lot of pressure on Mark Reynolds, and like many of the Diamondbacks, and they can field a team that's about 25 years of age. That's how young they are. They have delivered. Slowly hit to the right side, and DeRosa makes the play, one away here in the bottom of the second.
Zambrano, just like Webb, they seem like they're right on top of their game.
Right fielder.
Hit sliders there to Reynolds, who's a dead fastball hitter.
Zambrano, of course, will pitch with 3 days rest, as Lou Piniella told us that his plan is to go with Zambrano and then Ted Lilly and Rich Hill, and then come back with Zambrano and Lilly. Jason Marquis, who would have been the fourth pitcher, is available for bullpen activity. Here's Jeff Salazar with one out here in the second inning. Diamondbacks right fielder taking low for a ball.
Well, Salazar started the season, played 19 games with the Colorado Rockies, so he's been on two teams that have had probably the most fun year of baseball.
Nothing like ending up in postseason, and of course, if you played for the Colorado Rockies, you would have been in postseason and already have one victory, as they defeated the Phillies this afternoon in the top of our TBS coverage. Call strike to Salazar, and it's 2-1. Zambrano falling behind, three balls and one strike. He has not been especially sharp so far in the early innings here, has fallen behind several batters, 3-0. And behind Salazar, three balls and one strike. Ball four. And that is the first walk issued by Zambrano, who led the National League in giving up bases on balls with 101.
So far struggling with his ball to strike ratio. He led the National League in walks two seasons in a row. That's been one of his real struggles, is he has so much movement on his pitches, sometimes he'll get Lou Piniella saying a prayer.
Or something else. Here's Chris Snyder, the Diamondback catcher, hitting .252 in the regular season with 13 homers, 47 runs batted in. So Salazar is a base runner at first. The pitch is inside. And you were talking about Kirk Gibson, who is the bench coach, and his role for the Diamondbacks, especially with men on base.
Well, he's been a great bench coach for Bob Melvin, invaluable, and he does a great job of recording and timing the pitcher. If they're over the 1.5-second delivery to the plate, his runners are going.
And it's chopped to shortstop. And it could be two, and it is. 6-4, three double play. Snyder hits into the double play. That's what the sinker can do for Zambrano. And after two, no score.
Do I want to continue?
Of course.
I'm not paying. Schwab is. It's their new checking account. Schwab refunds all ATM fees at any ATM. Plus, they are giving me this ridiculously high interest rate. I mean, my money was just sitting in my old checking account, just kind of sitting there.
Looking for the perfect way to stay in touch?
No score after two, each team with a base hit, and Carlos Zambrano, the pitcher leading off in the third inning for the Cubs, and no breather for Brandon Webb. Zambrano has 20 hits and 81 at-bats. Two homers and five runs batted in. So one of the better hitting pitchers in baseball. And in the National League, they don't do it in the American. Swings and lines, a base hit to left field on the first pitch, goes all the way to the wall. Zambrano churning around, and the ball bobbled out there in left field by Burns. And Zambrano winds up at second with a leadoff double.
Well, he can't hit. You talked about the two home runs this year. He now has 12 home runs career for the Cubs. And this ball caught too much of the plate. Good hitting by Zambrano. Knows he's going to get that first pitch sinker from Brandon Webb. That ball up in the strike zone.
And it hit sharply because it wasn't that much into the gap, Ron. And just a shot past Eric Burns and left.
One of the things about this ballpark, very fast on the ground, infield and outfield.
And here is Soriano, who bounced to third his first time up. And the first pitch missing outside for ball one. So Alfonso Soriano, who missed the August series here with a torn quad, missed 18 games and still bothered by it. With the count 1-0 and fooled as was looking for a fastball, and he got an off-speed pitch, so it's 1-1.
Good curveball by Brandon Webb, who has one of the best in baseball.
Soriano, who led the Cubs with 33 home runs this year, and the pitch rides outside, 2-1 to the Cubs leadoff hitter. Zambrano on at second, and the Cubs looking to take the lead in this best of five series. The first two games here at Chase Field. Day off Friday in games 3 and 4 at Wrigley Field Saturday and Sunday. And a line shot foul down the right field line. And the count 2-2. Let's take a look now at Soriano's hit chart.
Well, you can see that most of his hits go to left field as he's become more and more of a pull hitter as he gets later in his career.
And again, we point out with the retractable roof open, normally a hitter's park even more so. And there's a slow breaking ball, and Soriano strikes out. So Brandon Webb with two consecutive breaking pitches, and Soriano goes down with a strikeout, and there's one away.
Well, just a beautiful overhand curveball. He took a little off this pitch, and it fooled Soriano. Both teams now with a runner at second have not been able to advance him with no outs.
So two breaking balls sandwiched around a fastball, and here is Jacques Jones, who walked his first time up. Zambrano with a lead at second base with one out. Ball one high. So Webb already with three strikeouts and one walk has allowed two hits, including the leadoff double here to Zambrano in the top of the third. Took something off that pitch, and the big cut by Jacques Jones, 1-1.
You see Jones shaking his head. Just so many weapons Webb has. Not only his sinker, he can change speeds on it. That was his good changeup, and he saw that overhand curveball.
Well, Zambrano has to work this inning and get out and stay at second base. And a shot that just barely getting away was third base coach Mike Wade. So a good bit of dancing by Mike Wade in the count 1-2. Wade, the coach at third, and Matt Sinatro over at first base. 1-2, took something off that breaking ball. Just getting a piece of it is Jones.
I think that's where the maturation of Webb has come from, that early in his career, he really just threw that sinker probably 75% of the time. Now he can get all three pitches over. He throws a fastball that'll go inside right at the hip of the left-handed hitter and come back over the plate.
And that sinker, which goes away from the left-handed hitter. 1-2 pitch. There is the sinker ball and strike three. So two out now for the Cubs. Soriano strikes out, and so does Jones. That's the fourth strikeout of the game for Brandon Webb.
This is that changeup again. See the bottom just drop out of that pitch. What makes it so effective? It has the same kind of break as a sinker, just the speed taking off as fools the hitter.
So a tough hitter now for Webb and Derek Lee, who was his first strikeout victim in the first inning. Zambrano with the lead at second. And the breaking pitch over for strike one. Cubs were seventh in hitting in the National League. And jammed beautifully. And Lee just gets a piece of it. And Webb is ahead of him 0-2.
Boy, it's almost like a left-handed slider coming into the right-handed hitter from Brandon Webb. The ball just bottoming out.
Well, I have to tell you this, that the Diamondback fans are many. They are seen and they are heard. And this ballpark is not dominated by Cub fans at all. They have the white pom-poms going, the crowd on its feet. Here's the 0-2 pitch, strike three. And Lee goes down on strikes, and so Zambrano, who led off with a double, is stranded at second as Webb strikes out the side after 2.5, still no score.
Today on DVD, step inside 1408.
It's an evil room.
One of the best Stephen King adaptations ever.
Drink responsibly.
Slow down. Enjoy an Aussie autumn.
Let's go out back tonight.
Where our new Top Cap sirloin is boldly seasoned. Seared for juiciness, slow roasted, hand cut to order, and served with Ball's Harvest veggies. Our new slow roasted sirloin has arrived.
Let's go out back tonight.
Enjoy an Aussie autumn.
Life will still be there tomorrow.
Let go. Go out back.
Moments ago, the crowd gave a hand to one of the great sports icons of all time, Muhammad Ali, the great fighter, former heavyweight champion, who now makes his home in Phoenix. And has a pretty good seat to watch this game, Ron Darling, as we go down to the bottom of the third inning.
As it should be.
Yes. Augie Ojeda will lead off for the Diamondbacks. And what a job he has done, really a career minor leaguer. And of course, Cub fans remember him. Spent 4 years with them, 148 games spread over four seasons, and what a job he has done since Orlando Hudson went down, a key factor for the D-backs, and he has delivered, takes strike one from Carlos Zambrano, and a chopper to second base, and DeRosa throws out Ojeda, one away. Well, you know the guy who does that killer John Madden impersonation on NFL Sunday. His name is Frank Caliendo, and he has a new show that will literally change the face of late night. See the all-new comedy Frank, TV coming November 20th to TBS. One out and Brandon Webb, who has six hits in 73 at-bats and takes strike one from Zambrano. One out here in the bottom of the third, and the foul at the plate.
Webb's not really a threat as a hitter, but Diamondbacks have a pitcher, Micah Owings, who is a threat as a hitting pitcher. He's had home runs, many home runs this year, and also Bob Melvin has said that he would use him as a pinch hitter if he needed him in the series.
Went 4-for-4 in a game this year.
With three doubles. Pretty good.
Here's a weapon. There he is, Micah Owings. And the fastball fouled off by Webb. One ball and two strikes. On deck, the top of the order, Chris Young. What a turnaround for this Arizona franchise. 3 years ago, they lost 111 games. And here they are, world champs as we know in 2001. And their last playoff appearance was a year later when they won the National League West.
Just a totally different team than they were in 2001 with all those veterans like Gonzalez, Schilling, Johnson.
Another foul at the plate, and of course you mentioned Randy Johnson, who was out on the field before the game, and he was one of the key losses for the Diamondbacks. And you'd say, well, you're going to lose Randy Johnson and still win the division and win more games than anyone in the league.
Yeah, you just think that you're going to need the big unit if you're going to win those games, but they've just literally come through every time with the clutch hits.
Two balls and two strikes, and strike three on the breaking pitch, and Webb goes down. Well, Zambrano facing hitters he's never seen before. So how does he do his homework, Mark Fine?
Yeah, well, I'll tell you what, Dick, I asked him about that. And if he does well tonight, he might have to send Jake Peavy a thank you card. What he said is since he hasn't faced these guys before, he'll look at tape of them facing Jake Peavy. His theory being that his good stuff is similar to the good stuff that Jake Peavy throws. Labored a little bit in the early going, obviously, but you have to give up a run, guys.
Well, good job, Mark. I think he does have stuff that's very similar to Jake Peavy, and that's a smart thing for Zambrano to do. And so far, so good as he is going through this lineup with the Diamondbacks.
1-0 the count to Chris Young, who started the bottom of the first for the D-backs with a sharp single to center field and was stranded at third base. Fouls this one off, and the count 1-1.
Well, the upside for young Chris Young is could be anywhere. They think he's going to hit 300 someday. 32 home runs, led major league rookies.
And chases a pitch outside the strike zone. 1-2. And while Young certainly doesn't, you know, compare to what Soriano has done as a leadoff hitter, Chris Young did hit 9 leadoff game home runs this year. Swing and a miss on the fastball, strike three. 2 strikeouts for Zambrano. He has 4 in the game, and after 3, still no score.
Hey folks, John Mann here today. Pie and Indians tears.
Frank TV premieres November 20th, only on TBS.
Fabric.
The MLB Division Series on TBS is brought to you by Sonic. It's not just good, it's Sonic good. And by Claritin Allergy Products. Live Claritin Clear.
No score between the Cubs and the Diamondbacks as we go to the fourth inning, and swinging on the first pitch is Aramis Ramirez, deep to right field. Under it is Jeff Salazar on the warning track to make the catch for out number one. And we talked to Bob Melvin, the Diamondbacks manager, and asked him after a scoreless early inning to take the temperature of what he thought the game was like so far.
Well, a lot of energy, but the pitchers are controlling the game right now. Both Webby and Zambrano have looked like they have pretty good stuff. Zambrano tuning it up a couple more right there at the end, has the off-the-body cutter, and Webby's got the sinker and his off-speed stuff going, so this game's going as advertised right now.
Hey, Bob, as a manager watching Zambrano throw this kind of game, does that make you think about maybe playing some hit and run, being a little more aggressive to try to get a run across the plate?
Yeah, you know, get some guys on there. We got CY on there and ran successfully the first time, but, you know, I certainly wouldn't argue that. You get two guys pitching games like they are right now, both top of the rotation guys who look like they're on their game. You got to put some pressure on them.
Bob, thanks very much. Good luck.
Thank you.
Bob Melvin, who replaced Bob Brindley as manager of the Diamondbacks 2 years ago, and actually replaced Lou Piniella as manager of the Seattle Mariners, who he managed for 2 seasons. And Piniella, of course, loving this year after taking a year off and spending time at Tampa Bay. He says, look, I wanted to go with a team that had a chance to win, and here he is.
And we were talking to him before the game, and I said, did you realize how many Cub fans there are? He said, no, they are everywhere.
0-1 the count to Cliff Floyd, a strikeout victim his first time up. Breaking pitch, fouled off, and it's 0-2. Chicago Cubs with great support from their fans, not only here in Arizona where they have their spring training camp, but throughout the country. They had a franchise record, 3.25 million fans at Wrigley Field, and very nearly 3 million fans on the road.
Well, that's the amazing part, is that it's so hard to get a ticket at Wrigley. Very much like the Red Sox at Fenway, very hard to get a ticket there, so a lot of the fans plan their vacations on going to visit different stadiums and watching their beloved Cubs.
You go to hotels on the road and you see a, you know, a sea of Cub uniforms or Red Sox uniforms, whatever city you're in, and they make a great weekend out of it. Two balls and two strikes to Cliff Floyd with one out here in the top of the fourth inning, strike three. So that is the sixth strikeout of the game for Brandon Webb. He struck out the side in the third inning after Carlos Zambrano, the pitcher, led off with a double.
Well, this is that sinker we talked about that starts inside and bends back out over the plate. We'll see at the pitch tracks that where the placement of that pitch was. Just at the letters, good call by Montague.
So with two down, nobody on, it brings up second baseman Mark DeRosa, who has one of the two Cub hits so far in the game. Takes a call strike. DeRosa, maybe the best bargain that Jim Henry made coming over from the Texas Rangers. And kind of a throwback player, very smart and versatile, can play almost anywhere.
Solid and the kind of guy that if you look at his stats, you might not say, boy, it's not a lot of production, but he's a winning ball player.
Single to right field, his first time up, and the count 1-1. And inside, and it hit him. And it got him on the left elbow, perhaps, and DeRosa will go down to first. A two-out base runner for the Cubs.
Ball ahead of him and trying to come inside to get him off the plate. That ball just nicked him on the elbow there by Brandon Webb. So much movement on Webb's pitch. No way for DeRosa to get out of the way.
So the Cubs, who've had a base runner in every inning of this game, have one here with two outs, and Giovanni Soto, who grounded to Reynolds at third his first time up. Tony Clark holding the base runner DeRosa on. Webb has allowed two hits, has walked one and struck out six, and of course hit a batter. There's a strike, 0-1. Cy Young Award winner in the National League last season. And a ground ball backhanded at short by Drew. The throw to first base in time. Drew making a good play on a hard hit ball, and that'll do it. One man left for the Cubs. We go to the bottom of the fourth, still 0-0.
Things you can do with one finger. Amuse a baby. Get to know your doctor. Save Holland. Trade stocks online globally.
See the inner space. And now you can drive the all-new Rondo for $179 a month with a 10-year, 100,000-mile warranty. So take immediate delivery of the all-new Kia Rondo only at Evergreen Kia, 92nd and Western. Take good care of my Kia, and we'll take good care of you.
And there's the line score here at Chase Field in Phoenix as the Diamondbacks come up in the bottom of the fourth inning against Carlos Zambrano. Zambrano has struck out four batters and walked only one and will face the number two hitters in the D-backs lineup, shortstop Stephen Drew. He takes inside ball one. Called out on strikes his first trip. You mentioned the home run that he hit at Wrigley Field to break a 2-2 tie back in July. And here's a drive hit deep to right field, way back and gone. So Stephen Drew hits another big one against the Chicago Cubs, and the Diamondbacks have taken a 1-0 lead.
This fastball right down the middle from Zambrano out over the plate. Beautiful level swing by Stephen Drew, and no doubt about that home run, Dave.
Eric Burns with a line drive to left field, and Soriano coming in, and you can see that he is hobbling a bit, definitely bothered by that strained quad. Slow coming in on it, but made the catch on Eric Burns for the first out here in the fourth.
And it's one of the reasons the Cubbies haven't played a lot more aggressively this summer because of the leg injuries to Soriano, who you always expect to steal at least 30 or 40 bases.
So Stephen Drew, and we mentioned back in the July 21st, the Diamondbacks were in a 6-for-16 stretch. And Drew hit the home run at Wrigley Field, won the game for Arizona 3-2, and the Diamondbacks then won 21 of their next 26. And that was one of the big turning points of the season for the NL West champions. So this crowd pumped up now. And the count 1-0 to Tony Clark, who struck out his first time up, takes a strike knee high, and it's 1-1. Interestingly enough, everyone talks about the Chicago Cubs power and the fact that the Diamondbacks have to scratch out hits. The Diamondbacks actually hit 20 more home runs than the Cubs during the regular season.
Well, this ballpark is just great for the hitters, especially the backdrop in center field.
It was a hitter's park for Drew. It is a shot. And getting out of the way, first base coach Lee Tinsley, and it's now 1-2 to the Arizona first baseman.
The problem with Wrigley Field is that during the summer months, it does blow out in Wrigley, easier to hit home runs. But in April and October, a lot of times, very cold there, wind blows in.
And that's when you have to play for one run early. And usually it pays off. Slice to left field. And Soriano going over, has a play, and makes the catch. Notice he makes that leap. And people are asking him about that, and he says, well, I don't want to wait for the ball to get to me, so I would rather go after the ball, and that's why you see him make that little jump before he makes the catch.
Well, of course, you know the former infielder, second baseman Soriano, who does it unusual, but has made a nice transition to the outfield.
But don't put him in center field.
No.
He was in center field earlier in the year, and one of the changes that Lou Piniella made, once he got used to the team, he said, I didn't really know this ball club, and so I had to feel my way, was to move Soriano to left. And a good fastball, foul tipped into the glove of Soto from Mark Reynolds, and the count strike one. So they're two out, nobody on base. Drew's leadoff home run, giving the Diamondbacks a 1-0 lead here in the fourth inning of game one. Fouled off, 0-2 now to Reynolds.
Well, I think that's what Lou Piniella was talking about, that during this season they've had to replace the catcher, a shortstop, the center fielder, and I think a manager of his stature is able to do those kind of things, make those wholesale changes right in the middle of the season, and then it changed for them.
Rarely do you change the key people up the middle, but that's what Lou did as Reynolds strikes out to end the fourth inning, but the Diamondbacks get a lead off of Zambrano with Stephen Drew's leadoff home run. It's 1-0 Arizona.
This is our truck.
The MLB Division Series on TBS is brought to you by Chevy, an American Revolution.
Ryan Theriault leading off in the top of the fifth inning against Brandon Webb. Takes a pitch inside for ball one. Theriault grounded out his first time up. Talking about the moves that Lou Piniella made, of course, Theriault's installation at shortstop was the key one in the infield. 1-2-0 for the Diamondbacks, 0-2-0 for the Cubs as Theriault takes a strike, 1-1.
Every inning is important for, here's Stephen Drew, the home run. Every inning's important for a starting pitcher. This one more important, though. After you've gotten a run, need to put a zero up there.
There's a strike on the outside corner. One ball and two strikes. Webb has given up two hits, a single to DeRosa in the second, and a double to Zambrano leading off the third. Third baseman Reynolds backing up. And throws over the head of first baseman Clark into the stands. And Theriault will take second base. And that should go as a throwing error for Reynolds. And the Cubs have a leadoff runner in scoring position.
Well, as he backs up, really lets that ball play him, and then he's so far away. Long throw to first base, not even close for Reynolds. See how he lets the ball play him, gets on his heels, and by the time he tries to throw that, not even close.
And even though he backed up, should have made the play because it was hit hard enough right at him. So here's Zambrano, who doubled to the left field wall leading off the third inning. Runner at second base, and there's a line drive caught by the shortstop, Stephen Drew. Getting back to second is Theriault. So Zambrano, hitting the ball solidly, is retired and just inches away from getting his second hit of the game.
Well, very unusual that you'd have your pitcher swinging in this situation. Most pitchers would be bunting to get the runner over, but not Zambrano, who's a fine hitter and line drive, and Drew was right in the proper position.
And fortunately, it was hit so hard that Theriault didn't have much of a chance to get a big lead and possibly get doubled off. So there's one out. Runner remains at second. Here is Alfonso Soriano, who is 0 for 2, struck out his last time up. And time is called. So another inning for Brandon Webb to labor over, as the Cubs have had at least a base runner on in every inning through the first five. And the first pitch to Soriano, ball one. Reynolds, the third baseman, with the throwing error and the first error of the series. Stepping off the rubber, and Theriault did not have much of a lead. Second baseman Augie Ojeda is keeping him close to second. Lang Soriano is a pull hitter in the infield and has a pretty good gap between first and second on the right side. That pitch in the dirt, good stop by Snyder. And the count goes to 2-0. Both pitchers, even though they have been in control, is kind of an odd game, Ron. As you would know, they've had the strikeouts going, but they've also been laboring in each inning.
They have. They've had their moments where they'll run through three or four hitters and then be behind two or three hitters.
Zambrano looking on as the Cubs, trailing 1-0, have the tying run in scoring position, and is a line shot to center field. Backing up is Young, makes the catch. Theriault goes back to second, and there are two men out. So two out here in the fifth inning, and Dick Stockton here with Ron Darling, a terrific major league pitcher, has a World Series win back in 86, and of course this year broadcast on SNY, the New York Mets, who did not make the playoffs.
Wow.
In a shocking collapse at the end of the year, maybe the biggest of all time.
Yeah, historical. And it was nice to see, though, Willie Randolph was going to be retained as manager, and I think that's a good move. They just fell apart at the end of the season. It was unexplainable. It was just here's a team that's had so much success and couldn't get the job done against second division clubs at the end of the season.
And of course the Phillies really had a great string against them, as it's gloved by Clark, feeding Webb for the final out. So the Cubs get a runner in scoring position and don't score. And after 4.5, it's 1-0 the Diamondbacks. And welcome back to Chase Field in Phoenix. The Diamondbacks lead the Cubs 1-0 in the first game of their best of five. Diamondbacks with 90 wins, the most wins in the National League, and the Cubs with 85 victories, the fewest wins amongst all playoff qualifiers, as Jeff Salazar takes ball one from Carlos Zambrano here in the bottom of the fifth inning. Salazar walked and was erased on a double play. Fouls it off, one ball and one strike. Mark Grace, Andre Dawson, two of the greats who wore Chicago Cub uniforms. Of course, Mark Grace, who spent 13 years with the Cubs, a lifetime 300 hitter and multi-gold glove champion, now a radio broadcaster because he finished his career with these Arizona Diamondbacks. Zambrano, the 18-game winner during the regular year, behind two balls and one strike to Salazar, who will be followed by Chris Snyder and Augie Ojeda. Took something off that pitch and gloved nicely by DeRosa, who throws him out. That ball was hit hard and was a much tougher play than it looked.
We've seen some fine defensive plays already in this game. DeRosa, you said it, Dick, made it look so easy. This ball up the middle, kind of backhands it, going away. And he does a nice job of getting rid of it really quickly. That allowed him, if it was a little off from the base, would give Lee a chance to tag the run to Salazar. But perfect throw by DeRosa.
One away for the Diamondbacks in the bottom of the fifth. And here's catcher Chris Snyder. Bounced into a double play his first time. Takes ball one. We have had only one inning tonight where the side has been retired in order, and that by Zambrano in the third inning. Fastball and a strike, one and one.
Boy, he is working quickly. We saw him working very slowly in the first inning, but he's picked up his pace, throwing strikes.
And he's got his rhythm now. Breaking ball in for strike two, one and two. So these young Arizona Diamondbacks, most in the playoffs for the first time. In fact, Eric Burns is the only one in the lineup amongst the regulars who has playoff experience. That with the Oakland A's. So it's a first time experience for most of these players. Two balls, two strikes, one out. And just blew him away as Snyder strikes out. That is the sixth strikeout for Zambrano when they're two down in the fifth inning. Well, here is tonight's Sonic trivia question. What three players have played in the most regular season games without reaching the postseason? Augie Ojeda with two out and nobody on base here in the Diamondback fifth inning. Bounced out his first time up. Switch hitter takes strike one.
Bob Elvin has said that Augie Ojeda is like his electric blanket. He knows exactly what he's going to get every day for him, as he's just a fine winning type ball player.
Great comfort. But you get from an electric
blanket, right?
One and one the count. Augie Ojeda, 32 years old, spent all of the last 2 years in the minor leagues. And what a boost he has given this Diamondback team when they lost Orlando Hudson, who's, you know, arguably one of the top two players on this club.
They've lost Randy Johnson, Orlando Hudson, when he broke his hand, his thumb, and also Chad Tracy. There's Orlando Hudson on the bench.
So there's always been someone to pick them up. Anybody, anytime, as you said at the outset, that was the call by Tony Clark. One ball and two strikes to Ojeda with two out. And off the glove of Zambrano, and chasing it on the throw to first, not in time. So Ojeda is safe with the third hit of the ball game for the Diamondbacks, off the glove of Zambrano. So a two-out base runner here in the fifth.
Good hustle by Ojeda as this ball up the middle. Zambrano gets a glove on it, not able to feel it. Good hustle by Terrio making that play to first base, but too late. See, Zambrano gets his glove on it. He's not in really great position to field anyways, but the play was Terrio as Zambrano wants to throw away his glove.
Not to blame the glove.
Yeah, well, it's not my fault.
Like Terrio with good hustle. And here is Brandon Webb throw to first base. And Ojeda gets back.
Always important, too, that that base hit there clears the pitcher. Brandon Webb was here, was up.
So if he's retired, it'll be the top of the order in the sixth inning for Arizona. 1-0. Diamondbacks lead on Stephen Drew's leadoff home run last inning. A 432-foot shot into the upper level in right center field. Grounded foul. 0-1. Carlos Zambrano, who allowed 23 home runs in the regular season, and of course the one run getting out of the ballpark here that's been the difference.
Just the opposite of Brandon Webb. 20 more innings for Brandon Webb, only 12 home runs allowed. That's just fantastic numbers.
And coming in, you know, the Cubs coming off the 45 home runs in September, a franchise record, they were counting on the long ball. Here's the 1-1, and it just misses outside. Two balls and one strike to Brandon Webb. He took a call, third strike his first time.
Tough to expect home runs off a pitcher, though, that has the second most ground ball outs in baseball.
Without question. Here's a lead by Ojeda, and a swing and a chop foul off. And it evens it at 2-2. Cubs' last appearance in postseason, 2003, when they came within 5 outs of getting into the World Series. They led the Florida Marlins 3-1, and then the roof caved in, as we know. Here's the 2-2 pitch, strike three, and Webb goes down for the second time, and the side is retired. 2 strikeouts in the inning for Zambrano, and after 5, it's 1-0 Arizona.
Slogan for you, baseball. Baseball can be traced back to an early... Turducken! Ah!
And this National League Division Series on TBS presented by Budweiser, official beer of Major League Baseball. 1-0 in favor of the Diamondbacks. They've out-hit the Cubs 3-2. And Derek Lee will lead off against Brandon Webb, so the part of the order, the 3-4-5 hitters to face Webb. And the curveball, base hit to left field. So Derek Lee with a leadoff base hit. That is the 3rd hit of the game for the Cubs, who have stranded 5 on base so far. And tonight's pitcher comparison is brought to you by Avis Rent-A-Car. We try harder.
And you see both pitchers just really pitching well. Only the home run given up by Zambrano to Drew is the only blemish on both those charts by those two fine young pitchers.
And the Cubs have had the leadoff man on 3 of the last 4 innings, and a strike to Aramis Ramirez, who is 0-2, grounded out and fly to right fielder Jeff Salazar. So an opportunity for the Cubs, and they have had opportunities before. Here is the 0-1 pitch, grounded foul, and it's 0-2. So Derek Lee, it was not a base stealer for the Cubs, but taking a short lead, held on by Tony Clark. Here is the 0-2 pitch. And it's swung on and missed. Strike 3. The ball getting away from Snyder. And Derek Lee will go over to second base. So Rodrigo Ramirez strikes out for the first out here in the 6th inning. And once again, the Cubs have a runner in scoring position.
Well, Snyder's usually great at blocking those pitches, but this ball almost bounced right on the plate. A changeup from Brandon Webb. Nothing Snyder could do on that wild pitch. And, of course, a break for the Cubbies. Even though a strikeout, Lee moves up to second.
Well, Zambrano led off with a double in the 3rd inning, and then Webb struck out the side, and then a 2-base error by Reynolds on his throw to first base. Cubs had a runner at second last inning, and now with a single and a wild pitch, 1 out, and the tying run is at second, and Cliff Floyd fouls it off. He struck out his first 2 times.
Well, when the Diamondbacks won their World Championship in 2001, their first game against the Cardinals in the division series was a 1-0 game also. Schilling against Matt Morris.
And time called.
There's Matt Williams. He's involved in that game. Great San Francisco Giant and Diamondback. World Series hero.
Real battler at third base. No balls and a strike to the left-handed hitting Floyd. Is a ball hit out to right field. Salazar in to make the catch. And the throw comes back to the infield as Lee goes back to second base. So Floyd's retired, and there are 2 out here in the 6th.
The Cubs have hit some balls hard, though, that have been right at the fielders. That one by Floyd. Soriano to center field. Zambrano, the line shot to Stephen Drew at short.
And here is the dangerous Mark DeRosa, who has been on base twice so far with a single. And he was hit by a pitch his last time up. So DeRosa, who drove in 72 runs in the regular season, at the plate with 2 out. And Derek Lee at second base. Breaking pitch inside for a ball. Mark DeRosa, who was once a starting quarterback at the University of Pennsylvania for 3 years, also played baseball there, but an outstanding athlete and obviously a smart fellow going to the University of Pennsylvania, as you are, having been a Yale grad.
Well, it's interesting here. Brandon Webb is trying to use his intelligence, trying to figure out with a base open, two outs, whether he wants to go up against DeRosa, who had that line shot single, or maybe test his mettle against the young Giovanni Soto called up from the minor leagues.
It's 2-0 to DeRosa. And a pretty good lead at second base for Derek Lee. There's a fastball in for the strike, 2-1.
Well, there's your answer from Brandon Webb on that 2-0 pitch. Just went right after him with a fastball.
Well, the Cubs have had their opportunities against Brandon Webb, but they have not been able to convert thus far. They have left five men on base, and they have another runner in scoring position with two outs. Here's the 2-1 pitch, just missing, and it's 3-1, and Webb wanted that one.
Well, it's been a pitch that's been called a strike, as Bob Melvin is shaking his head. Been a pitch that's been called a strike for most of the night here by Eddie Montague. See that ball in the pitch tracks? It looked like it might have caught some of the outside corner.
So Brandon Webb, like Carlos Zambrano, an 18-game winner, trying to pitch out of another jam. Here's the 3-1 pitch outside, ball four. So DeRosa draws a walk. That's only the second pass given up by Brandon Webb, and so Giovanni Soto will have a chance at the plate now. He's grounded out twice to the left side of the infield.
Oh, he's been outstanding. At the end of the season, of his 21 hits, 9 for extra bases.
Played in only 18 games. And after called up in September, hit to .426, only 24 years of age. But an opportunity here against Brandon Webb. Two outs, runners at first and second. Ball one, high and inside.
Well, Webb, who's their ace and a real horse, kind of guy that you could go 120 pitches, 125 pitches, but right now his sinker is up in the strike zone.
An innings machine is what he has been this year. Here's the 1-0 pitch, missing outside, and it's 2-0. And Snyder will go out to mound to talk to Brandon Webb. This is the first time in this game that the Cubs have had more than one runner on base in an inning. And the pitch count right now, here in the top of the sixth, 71 pitches.
I think Snyder's trying to go out to Webb and give him a little bit of a rest and tell him he's been successful because he's been getting ahead of the hitters. Right now, I think Webb feels, as a pitcher, when you're in this kind of game, and Zambrano pitching as well as he is, you feel like you just cannot give up a run or you're not going to win this game.
Each pitcher has struck out 7 hitters. It's 2 balls and no strikes to Giovanni Soto. Derek Lee is the runner at second base. Mark DeRosa with the lead at first. And the pitch is down low. 3-0, the count to Soto. On deck is Ryan Thurio. And Brandon Webb, one pitch away from loading the bases. There is Thurio, who has been on once in 2 trips tonight. Bob Melvin hoping his ace pitches out of it, and instead he walks Soto. So back-to-back bases on balls. Load the bases. And going to the mound will be Brian Price, the D-backs pitching coach. So already Snyder was out there, Ron, to settle him down, and now Price wants to talk to him.
Well, I think Price right now, you can tell that he's a little out of sync. His mechanics are a little off. That's why he's not able to throw the ball over the plate. Pitching coaches are great in this time. They come out and they'll just try to remind you of the simplified things, get the first pitch over, try to get ahead of the hitter. And, you know, a lot of times with bases loaded, pitchers feel that they're nervous, a little anxious. Well, the hitters get anxious, too, and sometimes that can work against them.
So the bases are loaded. You saw Derek Lee at third, Mark DeRosa at second, Giovanni Soto at first. Two out. The Diamondbacks lead 1-0. So there they are with the bases loaded, and Ryan Thurio, 0-for-2, grounded out and reached on a throwing error by Mark Reynolds. Last inning. So a big moment here in this game number one here in the top of the sixth inning, and Brandon Webb and the Diamondbacks trying to hold on to their 1-0 lead. First pitch, strike to Terrio. Webb now has walked three to go along with his seven strikeouts. In the bullpen is Pena, starting to warm up for the Diamondbacks. One ball and one strike the count. Tony Pena, who has been one of the ace setup men for Bob Melvin this year. One ball and one strike, and time is called.
They have two setup men, Tony Pena, who's the hard thrower, a guy who'll get a strikeout, and Brandon Lyon, more of the guy that'll go one or two innings, has all four pitches.
And of course, the closer, Jose Valverde, who led the major league in saves this year. Here's a 1-1 pitch. And a chopper over the head of Reynolds, and unable to make a play. Everyone is safe, and the run scores, and the Cubs have tied it up 1-1. Ryan Terrio with an infield hit. Derek Lee comes around to score, and unable to make a play on DeRosa at third, and the bases remain loaded, and the game is tied at 1-1.
Well, we're talking about that area right in front of home plate. Sometimes gets baked out in this Arizona sun, allows that chopper by Terrio to get over the head of Reynolds, who gives it a nice try. Good job by Stephen Drew of keeping that ball in the infield
and preventing another run from scoring. And here is Zambrano, who takes a call strike. Zambrano has hit the ball hard twice with a line drive double to the fence in left field his first time up, and then lined out as Drew had to make a leaping catch last inning. So Zambrano trying to help his own cause here in a 1-1 game, and a big cut and a foul off to the right, and the count 0-2. So Lou Piniella's Cubs are back in it. DeRosa going back to third base. Soto the runner at second, and Ryan Terrio, who delivers with an infield hit to tie this game. Cub fans on their feet. The count is 0-2 to Zambrano. And an off-speed pitch. Zambrano strikes out to end the inning. Seven men come to the plate, and the Cubs tie it up 1-1 as we send it to Ernie Johnson in our studios in Atlanta. Ernie.
All right, thank you very much, Dick Stockton. And for this TBS game break, it's great moments in history presented by Disney Parks. This look familiar to you, Big Hurt? Why don't you take me through this last year?
Well, we were fired up. It was a 12:30 in the afternoon game. So I just really want to get out to a good start for the team. And I just told myself, I'm not going to take many pitches today. I think both of those pitches were first pitch home runs. So I just want to get out early and help the team win. And things worked out well that day for us.
But those are moments in history.
All right, Ernie, thank you very much. And interesting comment by Cal Ripken, and that is a healthy emotion we're seeing from Zambrano tonight.
Well, I think he's keeping his sense of humor, which I think is a good thing, and getting excited at all the right times.
Well, tonight's Sonic trivia question was, what three players have played in the most regular season games without reaching the postseason? And the answer? Ernie Banks, Luke Appling, and Mickey Vernon. Fans, go to TBS Hot Corner on MLB.com to play more Sonic trivia powered by Nano Gaming. And the great Ernie Banks, let's play two. And of course, the symbol of the Chicago Cubs, you know, one of the happy Cubs over the years of heartbreak that this franchise has had, 99 years without a title.
Well, you couldn't ask for a better representative than Ernie Banks.
Top of the order, Chris Young leading off against Carlos Zambrano, takes a call strike. Young is 1-for-2 with a single, stole a base, and was stranded at third in the first inning. And the count is even now, 1-1. And it was Banks' record of 13 home runs in September that was eclipsed by Alfonso Soriano this past September. And there is Soriano, who appears to be hobbling a bit. Obviously not 100%, as the count runs to 3-1 to Chris Young. So Zambrano falling behind the leadoff hitter, On deck is Stephen Drew, who's accounted for the Arizona run with a home run, and then Eric Burns. Fastball foul back, and the count is full, 3-2. Well, you talk about the injury. Let's go back to August 5th when the Cubs were playing the Mets. Soriano came up lame running the bases in the third inning against the Mets, and he left the game with a quadricep strain and was sidelined for 18 games and also missed the series here when the Cubs came here. Meanwhile, Young on the 3-2 pitch takes a called third strike on the inside corner for the first out here in the sixth. And that is the eighth strikeout for Zambrano, who has given up one run. And here it is, Stephen Drew with a deep drive into the upper reaches, 432 feet. And Drew's home run accounting for the Diamondbacks' score. Here is Drew, and he takes outside ball one. One for two on the night. Aramis Ramirez is playing even with the bag and on the edge of the infield grass at third. One fastball in for a strike. Cubs have bullpen activity. Carlos Marmol is up in the bullpen, and he has been nothing short of sensational.
Well, we talked to Lou Piniella today. He said that he'd be the first guy out of the bullpen. He's a setup man with Bobby Howry. Now, the Drew household must be torn, right, Dick? We got J.D. Drew in a winning ball game today for the Red Sox, and Steven here with the D-backs.
Plenty to celebrate for the Drew family as Marmol slowly getting up. Josh Beckett with the four-hit shutout as the Red Sox beat the Angels earlier on TBS 4-0. There's a shot, base hit to left field by Drew. So Stephen Drew now 2-for-3 on the night and a one-out single here in the sixth inning.
Well, usually when Zambrano throws that pitch away, he has a little more of a sink there. That just ran right across the length of the bat. That ball up in the strike zone, and Ramirez not able to react in time on that line drive by Drew.
So Drew in his second year and hit 316 as a rookie last year, so he's a keeper. And here is Eric Burns, who is 0-for-2 on the night. Led the Diamondbacks in runs batted in, runs and doubles. So he's a big threat at the plate. Takes low and outside for ball 1-0. And tonight's leadoff line technology is brought to you by Travelers Insurance.
They can see the 9 there. That's the 9-foot line with the red arrow. That signifies a very good lead. If you get in the green, it's time to go. But there's other factors involved in stealing. Also, how long it takes Zambrano to deliver the ball, the strength of the arm of Soto. But there's that 9-foot line. Drew right on it.
Drew, with 9 stolen bases, has not been caught stealing at all this year. As Burns pops it up into short right field, coming on is Cliff Floyd, and he makes the catch for out number 2. And today's risk and reward, take a look at the Diamondbacks and their stolen base effort from the first half and the second half of the year.
I think part of that is that's when they started to get younger. And of course, Burns with the 50 stolen bases this year. Just had a career year, but I think that's what you do when you have a young team that doesn't is low in batting average and low in run scored. You got to try to force the issue, and that's what they did.
Here's Tony Clark, 0-for-2 tonight. Drew the runner at first with two away. Ball one outside from Zambrano. Tony Clark in his 13th big league season has 3 pinch hit homers this year. In fact, the Diamondbacks led the major leagues with 12 pinch hit home runs. So while they were at the bottom as far as hitting was concerned, they did distinguish themselves in ways like that, and also the one run games where they won 32 more than anyone in the big league.
Yeah, the best record.
So you knew they couldn't be last in everything and wind up with 90 wins run.
Well, they've really just had a magical year. They really have. It seems that every time they've needed that hit or well pitched game, they've gotten it.
Do you think they're the kind of a team that could lull you into a sort of a comfort zone when you play them because they don't have the big names, they have a lot of youth?
I think that's what it is. It's the unknown. You look at their lineup and you go, boy, they can be pitched to. Next thing you know, you lost 2 out of 3.
Fastball fouled back by Clark, and the count 1-1 to the 35-year-old Diamondbacks first baseman, one of the few players in their 30s.
There's Livan Hernandez. He's got some postseason experience, of course. 1997, he was the most valuable player in the World Series and the Championship Series.
And he is slated to go in game number 3 at Wrigley Field on Saturday. And in a slow hit ground ball, and coming over is Terrio to make the play, and that will retire the Diamondbacks. One hit, one left after 6 innings. We're all even at 1 apiece. One the score as we go to the 7th. Enter People Magazine's Sexiest Fan Alive contest, and you, guy or girl, could be in People Magazine's Sexiest Man Alive issue and win a VIP trip for two to a 2008 Major League Baseball World Series game. To enter, go to peoplesexiestfan.com. I'm going to wait until this game is over before I go to that.
Submit your name.
Now, Carlos Zambrano may be finished for the night. And Soriano, the batter, way ahead of that pitch in the count 1-1.
Well, there's a big discussion between Ted Lilly and Zambrano. You see Pinella comes into the picture and says, good job, big guy, you're out of the game. And I think one of the reasons is a couple of times this year, Zambrano has left the game with heat exhaustion. And if it's not that, then I think they're just trying to be real careful as Soriano hits the ball back to Webb. They're trying to be very careful with him because he's going to come back on 3 days rest. And so the pitch, trying to limit his pitch count, and Lilly's probably tomorrow.
And 85 pitches is what he has thrown. And Pinella told us before the game, he says if he goes 100, 105 pitches, that'll be plenty for Zambrano. So he has pitched well tonight, and 1-1 to score. Soriano is retired for the 4th time tonight. And here is Jacques Jones, who is 0-for-2, walked his first time up. There's strike 1 from Brandon Webb. So this is, as advertised, a pitcher's duel, Ron Darling, but it is not an airtight pitcher's duel.
That's right. They have stranded some runners.
Inside to Jones, and the third baseman, Mark Reynolds, is wide of the bag at third. The shortstop, Drew, is actually, as you see him playing on the outfield grass, deep at second base and at first as well. Breaking pitch is inside, 2-1 to the Cubs center fielder, hitting second in the order tonight.
Well, although if I was a Cub fan, Dick, I would not want to see Zambrano coming out of the game. It's been just outstanding.
Breaking ball hit sharply to Clark, who'll make the play unassisted for out number 2. So 2 infield outs recorded by Brandon Webb as Zambrano gets a breather, and he will be pitching in game number 4 on Sunday. And it brings to the plate Derek Lee, who singled his last time up and came around and scored on Ryan Terrio's base hit. Cubs were trailing 1-0. He led off with a base hit, went to second on a wild pitch. Bases were loaded before Terrio's infield hit got the tying run home. Fouls off the first pitch for a strike.
Well, when you take Zambrano out, you'd be asking, why do you want to go to your bullpen so early? But in postseason play, you have the days off in this division series. So that gives your relievers a chance to catch their breath and relieve their arms.
The 0-1 line foul into the stands down the left field line. So Webb is ahead of Derek Lee. No balls and 2 strikes. Lee, who led the Cubs, 317 batting average. Crowd on their feet. You saw the Cubs on the top step of the dugout. Good look at the 28-year-old right-hander from Ashland, Kentucky. Strike 3, and Derek Lee throws his bat. The ball got away from Snyder, and the out is recorded. The put out, 2-3. The strikeout for Webb, 1-2-3 inning as we go to the bottom of the 7th. And here we are, back in Phoenix with the Cubs and the Diamondbacks tied 1-1 as the D-backs come up in the bottom of the seventh inning, and the new pitcher is Carlos Marmol, who has really been a savior for this team and called up in May. DHL presents MLB delivery man, and tonight we focus on Marmol.
He's not only been sensational, he has been overpowering. Look at those strikeouts, two innings pitched, batting average against 149. Just outstanding for Marmol, 5-1 record in relief.
So fans, go to MLB.com to cast your vote for the 2007 DHL presents MLB delivery man of the year award. Marmol did not give up a run in 23 straight innings from the middle of August to the end of September, and turned out to be Lupinella's most reliable relief pitcher, and that hard slider that practically impossible to hit.
Well, he's just been great for Lupinella, going to in the middle of the games. He can not only go give you one, sometimes two innings, good Marmol.
Let's take a look at the way this series pans out schedule-wise. Of course, tomorrow night will be game two here at Chase Field. 10 p.m. Eastern start, and then following a day off, the series moves to Wrigley Field in Chicago. 6 o'clock Eastern on Saturday, and then Sunday on TNT at 1 p.m. Eastern for game four, if necessary. And if we have to come back for a game five, it'll be on Tuesday night at 10 p.m. right here on TBS. 1-1 the score. Mark Reynolds will lead it off for Arizona here in the bottom of the seventh inning. He is 0-2. And facing the 24-year-old Dominican Carlos Marmol. And the first pitch is taken for a strike. Carlos Zambrano worked 6 innings, allowed 1 run, 4 hits, struck out 8 batters, and walked only 1, and gave up the home run to Drew to account for the Arizona run. 1-1 now, the count to Reynolds.
Marmol has an interesting delivery. He really just flies at you with lots of his arms and his legs. Very deceptive. Hard to pick up the ball if you're the hitter.
And a little wild, wide, and the count 2-1.
What's going to happen to a young pitcher in his pitching in postseason? Tend to want to overthrow. And that's what he's done with that slider.
Of course, I remember the comment in our last break that Ernie Johnson in the studio with Cal Ripken, Frank Thomas, saying this game will be decided by the bullpen, and this is our first example.
High fly ball deep to left center field, way back. And this one is gone, a home run for Mark Reynolds. And the Diamondbacks regain the lead 2-1.
So talk about the bullpen. Marmol comes in, and after a 2-1 pitch, gives up a home run to Mark Reynolds, and Arizona leads it now 2-1.
Well, Marmol missed with 2 sliders, had to come in with the fastball, and you get a feeling of this anybody, anytime of the Diamondbacks as you see this pitch from Marmol right down the middle of the plate, and just a towering drive off the bat of Reynolds.
That's exactly what it was. That one almost reached the top of the line in which they cover the stadium, and that's how high it appeared. So Reynolds, who hit 17 home runs in the regular year, gives the D-backs a 2-1 lead, and Jeff Salazar fouls it off, and the count to him is 1-1. So here's the third baseman who's brought up from Double A, contributing in postseason in his rookie year with the Diamondbacks. 1-1 pitch, misses outside, 2-1.
Reynolds on the long line of those outstanding third basemen from that same area of Chesapeake, where you have David Wright, Ryan Zimmerman.
Salazar robbed of a base hit his last time up by second baseman Mark DeRosa, who made a great play going to his right. Meanwhile, the count, 2 balls and 2 strikes to Salazar. Nobody out here in the bottom of the seventh inning. Arizona leading 2-1. Trying to get the jump on the Chicago Cubs. And there's strike 3. And the herky-jerky delivery by Marmol really fooled Salazar.
Well, he can never pick up the pitch. I would say that Frankie Rodriguez, the pitcher for the California Angels, similar type slider. Lots of motion. backdoor slider. So nasty, Salazar couldn't even offer at him.
So with one out, here's Chris Snyder, 0 for 2, hit into a double play and struck out. Here's ball one outside. Many people felt coming into this game that it would be the best opportunity perhaps early in this series for the Diamondbacks to get the to take the lead because of the presence of Brandon Webb. Knowing that the Cubs, even though they won 85 games, the fewest among the qualifiers in the playoffs, a lot of people thought would be favored over the young Arizona team.
But you can have one ace who can determine a series. It happened in 1988 with the Dodgers, who didn't have a great run scoring team, and Hershiser led them with his pitching. It's ironically the same season he had the 59 inning scoreless streak, 42 sort of scoreless streak for Webb this season.
So sometimes all it takes is one to get the job. And if you look down the history of major leagues, you know, anytime in the last 25, 30 years, one pitcher would just steal the show.
Yes.
So right now, Brandon Webb has that one run lead. The count, 2 balls and 2 strikes. Just getting a piece of it is Snyder with one out. And the count holds it 2-2. Let's face it, the Diamondbacks coming out of a very tough division that was pitching strong throughout the year.
Well, you're facing a great pitcher every night, it seems, in that division, whether it's Francis from Colorado, Penny for the Dodgers. The Giants, who finished down, have two young great pitchers, and Lincecum and Kane.
Down is full, 3-2. Marmol giving off the leadoff home run to Mark Reynolds. One out and 3-2 to Snyder. Augie Ojeda waiting on deck for the Diamondbacks. And ball four. So Snyder draws a walk. So the runner at first with one out. And Lou Piniella going to the mound. And Connor Jackson has grabbed a bat, and he is on deck and will pinch hit for Brandon Webb if he gets to the plate. So Piniella coming to the mound to talk to Marmol. And we will take a break right now here in the seventh inning as the Diamondbacks try to add to their lead.
What makes the world?
Well, I'll wait till you tell me. Augie Ojeda with a runner at first, one out. Ojeda 1 for 2, singled his last time up with a shot off the glove of Zambrano. So the Diamondbacks looking to add to their lead. Took a 1-0 lead on Drew's leadoff home run in the fourth inning. The Cubs tied it in the sixth. And now the leadoff home run by Reynolds. Runner at first, and there's a high fly ball. Drifting foul and out of play. So it's 1-1 to the Diamondbacks second baseman.
Ojeda broke his bat on that drive to right field. As Ojeda just seems to be over, Marmol just seems to be overthrowing out there. That's probably why Lou went out there, kind of settle him down.
Tough spot for the 24-year-old, even though he has pitched so well in the month of September, to be thrust into this tight game in the latter stages. Brandon Lyon warming up for the Diamondbacks in their bullpen, and Bob Howry throwing for Chicago. And there's a shot down the right field line, base hit by Ojeda, and he's on his way to second, being held at third base is Snyder as the throw comes into the plate, and the Diamondbacks with runners at second and third and one out. And Connor Jackson will come up to pinch hit for Brandon Webb. So a double for Augie Ojeda, and the former Chicago Cub haunts his ex-mates with an extra base hit.
Well, fastball inside, but he got it up, did Marmol. Pull that down the line. And good job by Cliff Floyd getting to this ball, cutting it off and getting it in on time, which didn't allow the runner to score.
So the enthusiasm of the Arizona Diamondbacks and Ojeda getting a chance to shine in postseason after spending most of his career in the minor leagues. And here is Connor Jackson batting for Brandon Webb. 135 career pinch hitter. So Webb, pitcher of record for the Diamondbacks. The first pitch from Marmol is a breaking ball in for the strike. Connor Jackson hit 284 this season. And his 15 home runs matched his total from a year ago. And a breaking pitch in the air, center field, and tagging up, making the catch is Jock Jones. Here comes the throw, and it won't be in time as the Diamondbacks get the run. Scoring is Chris Snyder, an RBI for Connor Jackson, and Arizona has taken a 3-1 lead here in the seventh.
Well, I think we're starting to get a feeling on how Arizona wins their games. Runners on second and third, they're batting 300 as a team. Great sacrifice fly by Connor Jackson.
Ojeda held at second base as Snyder comes around.
Hanging slider from Marmol. Good job of Connor Jackson, not trying to do too much, getting that ball in the air. Jock Jones with a strong throw over the cutoff man's head.
So there are two out, runner at second base, and Chris Young with a big cut and a miss, strike one. So Brandon Webb will leave with a little bit of a cushion here. 3-1 the score in favor of the Diamondbacks. And that pitch did everything but hit Chris Young.
Almost went around him, it seemed.
Young with a first inning single and a stolen base has struck out his last two times. Ojeda with the lead at second base. Swing and a miss on a good fastball up in the zone by Marmol, and it's 1-2.
Young, a real steal for the Diamondbacks, getting him from Chicago White Sox for Javier Vasquez.
Hit two home runs against the Cubs in late August and a 5-4 win. So he has done damage against Chicago pitchers. Check swing. And there is Ed Montague, and he will not check. You talked about this with the first base umpire, Sam Holbrook.
Well, a lot of times what happens if the home plate umpire doesn't think he swung, the team, Chicago Cubs, will ask him to check with the first base umpire. If he doesn't think he did, he will take his time.
2-2 pitch and a check swing and a foul ball. Count remains 2 balls and 2 strikes. 24-year-old Chris Young, first rookie in Major League history to hit 30 or more home runs with 25 stolen bases. So already a mark of distinction for this young center fielder. Here's the 2-2. And the count remains even. Bob Howry continues to throw in the Chicago bullpen, but he's joined by Scott Ayer, a left-hander, and the only southpaw in the bullpen for the Cubs in this series. Here's the 2-2 pitch. Check swing, and he went. Strike three, said Ed Montague, and that'll do it. But 2 runs here in the seventh inning, and it was all started by Mark Reynolds with this towering home run to left field. 3-1 in favor of Arizona as we go to the eighth.
Only on TBS.
Come to daddy.
This National League Division Series on TBS, presented by Budweiser, official beer of Major League Baseball. There's the line score. 2 runs in the seventh inning to break a 1-1 tie, and the Diamondbacks lead 3-1, and they have a new pitcher in there, Brandon Lyon, and facing Aramis Ramirez, 0-3 tonight, and the first pitch, ball one.
The line has been outstanding all season long, appearing in 73 games. Got a good fastball, curveball, and change. He's only allowed 2 home runs in 74 innings pitched this season.
And the 73 appearances, second most on the Diamondbacks to Valverde. So Ramirez trying to get something going here. He'll be followed by Cliff Floyd and Mark DeRosa. Good pitch that jammed Ramirez, and the count now 1-2.
That's the great thing about Lyon. Lyon, when he comes in, is almost like a starting pitcher. He's got a full array, full arsenal of pitches with that fastball, breaking ball, changeup, as Valverde starting to get himself mentally ready.
35 holes for Brandon Lyon. You mentioned the great 1-2 punch setting up Valverde for the Diamondbacks. And the pitch is up high, 2-2. He and Tony Pena have more holes than any other bullpen tandem in baseball, a total of 65.
Valverde, there he is, the 47 saves this season.
In the air, deep to right field. Salazar is back on the warning track and makes the catch. So Rivera's going to the opposite field, is retired for out number one. Right now, let's take a look at the bulletin board presented by The Office on TBS. Well, it'll be the Colorado Rockies against the Phillies tomorrow. Franklin Morales and Kyle Kendrick will be the pitchers. The Yankees getting underway at Cleveland for the start of their series. Jinmin Hwang against CC Sabathia, a strong Cy Young candidate in the American League. And the Cubs and the Diamondbacks right here. Ted Lilly against Ron Davis. Line drive, right field. Salazar is there to make the catch for out number two.
Nice job by Lyon so far. Two pretty good hit balls to right field, though, right at his right fielder from both Ramirez and Floyd.
And it's a Doug Davis, of course, and Ted Lilly in a battle of left-handers tomorrow evening.
Lilly had an outstanding year for the Cubs this season, and Davis, who pitched in tough luck early in the season for the D-backs.
Two down to Mark DeRosa, who has been on base three times tonight. Single, hit by a pitch, and walk. And was a central figure in that sixth inning as he fouls off the pitch. Strike one when the Cubs tied it up, sent seven men to the plate. Brandon Lyon quickly with two outs here in the top of the eighth inning. Breaking pitch, ground ball, fair. Reynolds gets his man, and a 1-2-3 inning for Brandon Lyon. And we go to the bottom of the eighth inning. It's the Diamondbacks 3 and the Cubs 1. Diamondbacks lead 3-1. Have out hit the Cubs 6-4. Breaking the 1-1 tie with two runs in the seventh inning, and Stephen Drew, who accounted for the first Arizona run with a leadoff home run back in the fourth inning, will face the new Cubs pitcher, right-hander Bob Howry, who after a slow start became an effective setup man and was sizzling in September with an ERA of 0.89.
What a great base on balls to strikeout ratio, 19-72 punch outs. And he has been outstanding in September, 1.80 ERA, but he gives up almost a run more when he pitches on the road.
And the foul back, one ball and one strike to Drew. Left-handed pitches are a paltry 192 against Bob Howry, who appeared in a team-high 78 games for the Cubs.
Well, very unusual because he struggles against righties who are batting 283 off him. One of the reasons is Howie's best pitch is his changeup that he uses against the left-handed hitters.
One ball, one strike. Drew leading off in the eighth inning. Fastball fouled off to the left. One ball and two strikes. Howry is the third pitcher of the night for the Cubs. Carlos Zambrano worked six innings, gave up one run, struck out eight. And Carlos Marmol came up and gave up two runs on two hits in one inning of work. Ball and two strikes to Drew. 2-2.
Really has been the recipe for success for the Diamondbacks this season, though. Just get enough runs and then turn it over to that great bullpen. Lyon doing his job in the top of the eighth.
And if the Cubs had the lead, they would rely on their great bullpen. So it's again Frank Thomas saying the bullpen will decide it. It was getting the runs and let's turn it over to them. Mowry's 2-2 pitch. And it's popped up and foul and out of play. Kind of a homecoming for Bob Howry, who fan with a souvenir to show it all, grew up less than 15 miles from Chase Field. And he attended Deer Valley High School in Glendale, Arizona. Of course, Glendale is where the Super Bowl will be played this year. All the Diamondbacks are thinking about perhaps getting to a World Series. But first things first. Strike three, and Drew goes down for out number one. Well, this young team has the lead, Mark Fine, and they're making it stand up.
Yeah, they do, Dick. And, you know, the motto's anybody, anytime, right? Well, talking to the team yesterday, you would have thought it might have been young enough and dumb enough. A number of the players said, yeah, we're inexperienced, but maybe we don't know any better to get nervous in this big-time situation. And Derek Lee said the same thing as well. He hoped experience made a difference, but he wasn't sure that it would, Dick.
All right, Mark, thank you very much. So one out, and Howry will be facing Eric Burns, who is hitless in three trips tonight. Of course, as the series goes on, you know, you're in position to take the lead, but can you close it out? And that would be the question for this young team, if it got to that point.
Well, I think the one advantage they have is they've been pulling on the same rope altogether all season long, so that really helps when you have star players that you have to rely on. Sometimes guys sit back and watch, but everybody, they're not talented enough as far as big name players to have anyone just stand out. They've all got to do it together, and they've been doing it all season long.
And Bob Melvin has been the maestro for all of that, has encouraged it. A swing and a miss, and no balls and two strikes to Eric Burns. In fact, you talk to a lot of the Diamondbacks, they go in and they say Bob Melvin is like one of the players in the clubhouse.
Well, he is very even keeled. I know a lot of scouts that have watched the Diamondbacks this year say it's one of their favorite teams to watch. They run everything out. They play nice fundamental defensive game.
Here's the 0-2 pitch. And chasing it, Eric Burns strikes out. So Bob Howry comes in and strikes out the first two batters he faces. Two down here in the bottom of the eighth inning, and Tony Clark coming to the plate. Clark tonight 0-for-3.
Tony Clark, the veteran, of course, is the author of that Anybody, Anytime. One of the most likable players in the game.
And has spent some big years with the Detroit Tigers in the late 90s when he hit home runs. 32 one year, 34, 31. Long ball hitter and a power hitter, but a valuable guy to have around your club right now.
I think even more valuable this year than probably any point in his career, because there's so many young players, they're going to emulate the older players on your team. When you have a guy like Tony Clark who hustles all the time, who runs everything out, is a good clubhouse leader, those are the kind of guys you want in your clubhouse.
Two down, and the count, one strike to Clark. And it's up high, 1-1. Interesting news today in baseball that Walt Jocketty, the general manager of the St. Louis Cardinals, will not be back. And that a total shock, considering that right now the Cardinals are still the defending world champions. Hard to believe after winning the World Series, first one since 1982. Good baseball man, Walt Jocketty, and the pitch misses, and it's 2-1 now to Clark.
Yeah, he's one of the class acts in baseball. He won't be unemployed too long.
Made some good moves, and just sometimes things don't work. And you want to talk about adversity, that's a capital A with the Cardinals this year. Howry working to Clark, 2-1, and a fly ball hit to left field. Soriano drifting back and makes the catch. The 1-2-3 inning. So the Diamondbacks are retired, and the Cubs come up in the top of the ninth, trailing 3-1. Top Top of the ninth inning and the last chance for the Chicago Cubs, who trailed the Arizona Diamondbacks 3-1, and Jose Valverde, who led the major leagues in saves this year with 47 and saved all four Diamondback wins over the Cubs this year, gets the call.
Much like the Cubs, Carlos Zambrano, a very emotional pitcher, is Jose Valverde. Led major leagues, like you said, Nick, with 47 saves, fastball and split finger.
Giovanni Soto takes strike one. Soto 0-for-2, walked his last time up. So it's the bottom third of the batting order for the Cubs here in the bottom of the ninth inning. Playing Soto to pull in the infield. Reynolds is deep behind the bag at third. Valverde's 0-1, breaking ball, and it's hit into the air to center field. Chris Young, plenty of room, one out. Well, stay tuned for Inside MLB, presented by Captain Morgan. And tonight, Ernie, Cal Ripken, and Frank Thomas will have highlights of today's game. And Craig Sager will look ahead to game one between the Yankees and the Indians, which will take place tomorrow. So Ryan Terrio with one out. And a two-run lead for the Diamondbacks, and Darrell Ward has grabbed a bat, and he is on deck and will pinch hit in the number nine slot. Fastball to Terrio, strike one. Terrio tied the game for the Cubs in the sixth inning with an infield hit with the bases loaded, getting a run in. But the Cubs weren't able to score any more runs, and then the two-run seventh inning, with Reynolds with the leadoff home run and the sacrifice fly by Connor Jackson, has been the difference. Terrio is 1-for-3 with a single, reached on an error, fouls it off, and Valverde's ahead of him, two strikes.
Well, that's the one thing you get with Valverde. The games that he has struggled on, he struggled with his control of his fastball, seems to be on point tonight.
He has averaged 11 strikeouts for every nine innings, and now second base umpire Gene Greg Gibson is coming in and pointing to somebody in the stands.
There was something behind a plate that was shining, almost a pinkish reddish light, by this gentleman right here in the blue shirt.
Yes, right there, and it's...
What's he thinking?
And it doesn't look like he's just a fan. It looks like he's working in some capacity. Two strikes to Terrio. Working out of the stretch. 1-2 now to the Cubs shortstop.
Valverde throwing awfully hard. 96 miles an hour on that fastball. Terrio, one of the big changes for Lou Piniella this year. In the middle of that lineup, middle of the diamond, shortstop.
Diamondback fans on their feet, still waving those white pom-poms. One ball and two strikes, ready to erupt if Valverde could get the second out. And now the Cubs are down to their last out. And Darrell Ward will come up and pinch hit in the pitching spot. So Darrell Ward, who has been the best pinch hitter for the Cubs this year, coming to the plate at his career best batting average, 327 in his 10-year career in the big leagues. Played in 79 games and the last hope for the Cubs. Infield at second and short, playing deep and on the outfield grass, and Ward takes ball one outside. So great bullpen work by the Arizona Diamondbacks. Brandon Webb going seven innings, allowing one run on four hits, striking out nine. Brandon Lyon working an inning, retiring the Cubs in order. And now Jose Valverde trying to do the same here to close it out. Valverde likes to take his time, and Ward steps out.
Well, Darryl Ward, of course, is the son of two-time All-Star ex-Major Leaguer Gary Ward.
Trying to keep it alive. If he does, Soriano, the leadoff hitter, would be on deck. Fastball, and that missed. So it's 2-0, and Valverde wanted that one.
Well, Eddie Montague's had more of a higher strike zone today. This ball looks like it could be on the knees. Seems like it catches a lot of play, but Montague's strike zone has been higher in tonight's ball game.
And he has been consistent. He has not called that a strike all night. 2-0 the count with two out. Hitters count here, and it's low. Ball three, so Valverde is one pitch away from allowing the tying run to come to the plate. And Soriano waiting on deck, who led the Cubs with 33 home runs this year. Now time called as Valverde tying his right shoe and in no hurry. And those Hardy fans out there still showing that 1908 symbol. But this is a best of five, and the first team to three will move on to the National League Championship Series on TBS. Here's the 3-0 pitch in there for a call strike. Valverde, 28-year-old Dominican right-hander at 6'4". First year as the Diamondbacks' only full-time closer. Shared that role last year with Julio Jorge, who's now with the Rockies. So Ward is in there. Three balls and one strike. Ball four, and Ward walks. And that will bring the tying run to the plate. So there is still hope for the Chicago Cubs as Soriano comes up.
Well, definitely is hope after watching Soriano in September hit 14 home runs, red hot. Not a good situation for Valverde to put himself into.
And we're going to have a pinch runner. Ronnie Cedeno will go in and run for Darryl Ward. So Soriano the batter. There is Cedeno, who was the shortstop. And Terrio took his place. Cesar Asturias was the shortstop in the opener. But here's Soriano, who's 0 for 4 tonight. Outfield playing deep and straight away for the Cubs left fielder. Strike one. Arizona Diamondbacks. Improbable when you look at the makeup of the team, the youth, the fact that they were last in hitting and all the rest. But winning 90 games in a tough division. And a good bullpen trying to take a 1-0 lead in this division series over the Cubs. Foul back, and the count 0-2. And now the Cubs down to their last strike.
Now Soriano has good memories here, though, Dick, right? The home run in the World Series off Schilling.
And the Diamondbacks eventually winning on Luis Gonzalez hit to beat the Yankees. Three to one, the Diamondbacks lead. Runner at first, two out, 0-2 to Soriano. And a ground ball to shortstop. They get the force, and the game is over. And Jose Valverde shrieks with joy as the Arizona Diamondbacks have taken game one from the Chicago Cubs, winning 3-1 and getting two runs in the seventh inning to break the tie. And terrific pitching tonight by the Diamondbacks, their starter and their bullpen.
How did the Diamondbacks win 90 games? Well, they showed you tonight how they win 90 games. A great pitching effort from their ace, Brandon Webb. They went to the bullpen, which saved it for him, and just enough hitting with a couple of home runs and a sacrifice fly to beat
the Cubs tonight.
And tonight, Chevrolet player of the game is Brandon Webb, who struck out 9. And in recognition of his outstanding play, Chevy will donate $1,000 to Major League Baseball's youth baseball charities. Chevy, an American revolution.
Well, he just, his stuff was moving so much, his breaking stuff and his changeup, even his fastball. So he had a little control issues, but other than that, when he got ahead of the hitters, he had lots of weapons to put them away.
And the home runs you mentioned by Stephen Drew in the fourth and Mark Reynolds in the seventh inning, both leadoff home runs. The difference as Brandon Webb, the 18-game winner and last year's Cy Young Award champion, pitches the Diamondbacks to the lead, and a smart pitcher's duel. Carlos Zambrano, who came out of the